did the high waters brought on by this afternoon storm. Stop what you're doing right now. Take a look at this video. This is from Pittsburgh's Oakwood neighborhood. Just into our newsroom, several cars submerged underwater, one of them with the engine still running. Amazingly, right now, we are hearing of no serious injuries reported here. Heading into town, high water leading into the front doors of the Hilton Hotel right downtown. Guests having to tread carefully in and out of the hotel. A high water in that area also affected guests going to the Three Rivers Arts Festival. This video also just into our newsroom. Heavy rain, wet roadways. This is Mason Town, Fayette County. No reports of any severe weather damage have come in from that area. And our team coverage on this weather watch takes us to Duquesne, the city of Duquesne next. A church struck by lightning. Channel 4 Action News reporter Ashley Hardway shows us more than just the steeple was damaged.
Witnesses tell me they saw a flash of light, heard a loud bang, and the next thing they knew, the top of the church was falling down. Stonework from the 90-year-old church sits on the sidewalk behind caution tape. One of the stone spires was destroyed when lightning struck Grace Church in Duquesne Friday night.
How much damage is there? I have no idea. You can see it extends, you know, it's pretty bad up there.
I was walking and I seen that the sky just got real light, and then I heard a real loud bang, and it hit the church over there, and the bricks and everything fell down.
Lisa Coulter lives nearby and saw it all happen. She started to clean up.
We went over there and we took the bricks out the street so the cars wouldn't run it over because it fell in the street.
The strike also destroyed a telephone line and possibly sabotaged some lights inside the church.
I was scared. It's something like, I've never seen nothing like that before.
Very expensive. I have no idea what it's going to cost. I called the insurance company. They always have somebody out here on Monday. So how much damage? I don't know. There might be $20,000, $30,000. I'm not sure.
The church's president tells me they still hope to hold Sunday services here despite what happened on Friday evening. In Duquesne, Ashley Hardway, Channel 4 Action News.
Oh, it's hard to believe. All right, thanks, Ashley. And we continue to get information about power outages into our newsroom. Right now, Allegheny Power is reporting 1,959 customers without service. And Duquesne Light is reporting just under 2,000 customers out as well. We're still waiting to hear back from Penn Power. You can track storms 24 hours a day online at thepittsburghchannel.com. Check out our live interactive radar. You'll find it under the weather link on the left side of the homepage. As soon as the severe weather began, viewers started sending us pictures and videos to our website, thepittsburghchannel.com. This is from Washington Plaza and Center Avenue near the Mellon Arena, where cars had a tough time getting through the water there. And we want to thank Sue Weiss for this picture of flooding on Route 51 earlier this evening. You can see the cars having trouble moving through the water there. And Gus 026 sent us this picture from Route 885 in Hayes. That's in the city. Be sure to upload your pictures and videos through the U Local link on the homepage of thepittsburghchannel.com.